to the show. My name is Anisha with a T, and we're still chilling right here at the Cup Kisementi with Hans. Now, the beauty of this show is because he is born again. I am Muslim, and the gentleman right behind the cameras is a Rastafari. You see the unity that we're bringing right here, and I feel like that is what you're trying to bring. That's what you're trying to preach out here, because, like I said before we cut off, are different religions allowed to come? Like me, will you invite me, or I have to first become born again to come to the show? Yes.
The ministry is not only about one person teaching the message, but it's also it has a Bible college, so it's called Carriage Bible College, and everyone who is older than 17, 18 years is welcome to come. So when I say everyone, it is, and I mean everyone, yeah, male, female, but people who are not Christians but are still interested in the Bible and in getting taught, they are also welcome to come and to receive what we want to give in that school. Yeah, so it's for anybody.
You know, when I was growing up, because me, I'm Muslim, I'm going to say that again, I'm sorry. But they're Protestants, right?
Yeah.
Then they're Catholics,
yes.
Right? Then they're Seventh Days and they're...
Yes.
What exactly, like, let me even write it down. Imagine, like, this is the Protestant,
uh-huh.
These are the Catholics,
yes.
And these are like the Seventh Days, and here are the born agains.
Yeah.
Is it a religion? You know, what makes someone jump from being Protestant into this bucket of being saved?
Yes. Well, you have all those different categories, Protestant, Catholics, and born agains. But if we talk here in Uganda about born agains, we talk about a certain denomination, yeah? It's a certain church or a group of churches. But actually, when you read in the Bible what the Bible says about being born again, it is not about going to a church. No, it's about receiving Christ in your life and receiving the life of God from above. Actually, the Bible says about being born again, it is about being from above. Yeah. So there's nothing to do with a church or a denomination. So you have born again people in the Protestant church. You have them in the Catholic church. Yeah, so, and you can go on.
So what you're trying to say is that you can be a born-again Protestant.
Yes.
You can be a born-again Catholic.
Yes, yes.
So born-again is not a religion?
No.
Explain that.
It's not, well, it's just like if you are born into a family, you become a child of that family, yeah, of those parents. So, but if you are born from God, you become a child of God. So which means you enter into the family of God. Yeah, and the family of God is not limited to certain churches. No, you can be part of a family and going to that church. You can be part of the family of God and you go to another church. Yeah, so, but the common denominator is that you are a child of God by rebirth, by being born again. So it's actually, it has not to do with your flesh, but it has to do with your spirit. Yeah, so you become born again in your spirit. Yeah, your spirit changes. So on the outside you will not change,
but
the inside will change. Yeah, you have a different spirit on the inside of you, and that's what the Bible calls being born again.
Wow. So, you know, let's clarify this. That means the Catholics, Protestants, and the born again all believe in. They all use one book.
Yes.
You get it.
Yes.
It's not differentiated.
Yeah.
That means it's man-made. The differences are put there,
yes,
by man himself.
Yes, definitely.
That,
yes,
book has the same thing. That means if, yeah, I am Protestant, I'm going to read the same exact text that you are going,
exactly,
to read.
Exactly.
That is something you've clarified, because, you know, most times we don't go to born-again churches because we believe that is also a sect on its own, because that is how people have put it out. Now let's talk about the sinners, you know, because Urban Television is not a TV for sinners, but we attract an age group of people who are battling things in their lives between an 18 and like 35. You know, there's temptation,
yeah,
you know, people are getting into campus and, you know, people are doing all lots of things. And there's a certain point in your life where you reach, I've seen too much, God is not going to forgive me. How do you handle situations like that? You know, she's 26 years old, she's had over 3 abortions, she's slept around, she's probably HIV positive, she doesn't know who to turn to. Is this the miracle we've been waiting for? The call is what Andrew Womack Ministries is giving us.
Yeah, well, actually, it doesn't matter what you have done in your life. So for God, it doesn't matter when you do a small sin or a big sin. It is no different from God. Because we all fall short of the glory of God. That's what the Bible says. So whether you are a big sinner or a small sinner, we all need God's forgiveness. Yeah. So for God, that does not make any difference. Yeah. So if you, there are many people in the Bible which have written parts of the Bible who were murderers. Like David, he was a murderer. He was an adulterer. Yeah. Moses, he was a murderer. Paul, who has written almost all of the New Testament, he was a murderer.
Yeah? He was a murderer?
He was a murderer. He had killed many Christians before he became a Christian. Yeah. So those people got used in a special way. So I just want to encourage anyone who thinks that he is a big or sees a big sinner. Well, you for God, you are not a big sinner. No, you are accepted in Jesus Christ. If you believe what he has done for you at the cross, all your sins are forgiven in the past, in the present, and in the future even.
Well, so yes. You believe that there's heaven and hell, right?
I do, yes.
So in order to go to heaven, you have to have believed in the word of Christ. And if you haven't, you will not go to heaven.
Well, the Bible says that we have to believe in what Christ did on the cross, that he died for our sins in order to receive forgiveness. And that's what we are preaching. But that's not the only thing we are preaching, because that has to do with your eternal destiny. But the gospel is much bigger than only eternity. It has to do with our day-to-day life. It has to do with our health. It has to do with our finances. It has to do with everything in our life, with marriages, with relationship. So it's not only a ticket to heaven. It has to do with a better life here on earth.
Before we get into the ministry's question, one last question. If I do not believe in Jesus Christ, but I am a good person, I mean, I help people, I'm a good-hearted person, I give charity, will I go to heaven?
Well, the Bible says that you have to believe in the Son of God in order to receive eternal life. Yeah, so if you have the Son of God, then you have life. If you don't have the Son of God, then you don't have life. That's what the Bible teaches.
So in other words, I won't go to heaven.
Well, that's not up to me to say anything about that.
Okay, that's a nice one. So yeah. I know on a certain day, Andrew will be coming in. So I want to know the day that he'll be coming in. So probably yes. I'll probably drop by and they will also come by. We need to know about the details.
Yes, Andrew Womack, who is actually heading this ministry, he is coming to Uganda on the 19th and the 20th of October. That's a Friday and a Saturday. And he will have meetings at the Lugogo hockey grounds from 6 p.m. on. So two meetings, Friday evening and Saturday evening, and everybody is welcome. It's for free. But don't come too late, because it will be packed. So the gate will be open from 2 on, and everyone is welcome.
Please, we're welcome, because it's for free, because we are used to our pastors charging us this entry fee. And when we reach there, we have to buy holy rice. And after we buy holy rice, we have to pay for tables worth 1.2 million shillings to receive the glory of Jesus. But this is different. So I am most definitely going to be there. You make sure that you turn up there, because we all need some God in our lives, don't we?
Amen.
My name is Anisha with the T. Thank you very much for being part of the show. Bye.